This
Thank you.
conference will now be recorded.
Correct. Fury should work, but let me check once again whether they have added the Fury tiles or not. Okay.
Thanks, sir.
Okay. So any questions before starting class?
So not for now.
Okay.
Just to ask you a question.
Yeah,
high level, question.
Yeah.
I remember when we did SDMM, S4SDN, SDMM, we did MRP, but you know, not as high as this level, I believe. But they said actually PP, SPP, it's come with PP and APO. Is that right now or not? What do you think about it?
Okay. It is not completely APO. Okay.
Yeah.
In APO, you have a module called PPDS.
Yeah.
That module has come into the PP in S4HANA.
Okay. Got it. Thank you.
Okay. Only that module only.
Okay. Thank you.
Yeah. Okay. And remaining modules, it went to IBP. Two modules, it went to IBP. And GATP, it came to S4 only, but not all the features of GATP. Only ATP has come. But PPDS complete module has come into S4 HANA PP.
Oh, great. Okay. Okay. Got it.
Okay.
Thank you.
Yeah. Okay. Okay. So Jamal, actually in a previous class, we are discussing on the creation of the material. And I explained you the different fields in material master creation. And I will continue the same now.
Okay.
Okay. So before that, let me check once again the apps here for this user. I'm just checking purchase orders.
It looks like it has a lot of, yeah.
Okay. Same issue is there, but once again, I will raise to Murali on this Fury tiles. Okay. Data is opened actually. Okay, I think there is no tiles for manufacturing. I'll once again check with Murali. Okay, and I will come back. So I opened the product. Yeah, I'm going to open in GUI only. Okay. So in previous class we are creating the material that is called the Honda City. I will continue the same now. Honda City.
MM02.
Yeah, correct. Let me check the views, extended all views. This is MM01 creation.
Yeah. Okay.
In last class we created MRP 1, 2, 3, 4 views. Now I will explain you the work scheduling view. the PP related views are MRP 1234 and work scheduling view. And this accounting okay. and costing is for costing purpose. Yes, please.
One second, please.
Yeah.
Can you go back to the fields that you are trying to select?
Views?
Yes. Can you go back one step, please?
Yeah, 1 minute. Okay.
Yes. Now, for PPM point of view, is these views that you are collecting basic data 1 MRP now 1 to 4, is these are the mandatory fields when you work any place, anytime, even discrete process or repetitive anytime, these are the three fields are mandatory that you are collecting, is it correct?
Correct. RP 1234 and work scheduling view. These five are the important. These five only for any kind of business. Okay. Apart from this, uh-huh. if you want to use APO PPDS in S4 HANA, then you need to see this advanced planning. This is for okay. APO PPDS. Okay.
I'm sorry.
This view is required.
Okay. When you work with
remaining five is mandatory.
Okay. When you use the advanced planning, because when you talk the sometimes in the middle of the talking is something is breaking. So can you
sorry?
Can you tell me one more time when you use the advanced planning?
Planning is nothing but if you want to use PPDS, there is a module is there in AP advanced planning. In that you want to use a PPDS module, production planning and detailed scheduling. If you want to use this module, you to this view, you won't find this view in ECC.
Okay,
this is only in S4 HANA
and also on the top basic data one, also, right?
Yes, basic data one is mandatory for any material creation.
Okay,
but what about the
basic data one?
Yeah, no, I'm sorry,
yes, please.
And work scheduling is also right.
Correct.
What about forecasting? No, usually.
Yeah, I'm coming to that.
Okay, perfect. No
problem. I'm coming to that point. Okay, so if you want to use advanced planning, you need this one. Otherwise, remaining five is important things. Now, forecasting. Actually, this is we are not using frequently in manufacturing. This is also related to a manufacturing, but this is specific to if you want to use MRP type, MRP planning, which is having the type forecast planning. That time only we will use this tab. Okay, that is one point. Generally, for forecasting planning, we are using APO module, not the ECC module or S4 HANA. We will use the APO. In APO, there is a module DP and SNP. These two modules we will use basically for forecasting planning. In S4 HANA world, we will use the DP actually, IBP. Okay, demand and supply. there is a two modules in IBP. So these we will use generally for forecast. But if you want to use forecast planning in S4HANA, you need this tab details also. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Any questions?
No, carry on, please. Okay. Thank you, sir.
Okay, thank you. But this advanced planning, I will explain you at the end. End means after after completion of this S4HANA, then I will explain what is a PPDS and advanced planning. Okay. So now I am.
Can you going also to, select the accounting one and accounting two?
Yeah, I will enter the mandatory fields in accounting one and accounting two.
And what was the other fields after the accounting?
Tabs, you mean to say?
Accounting one, accounting two.
Mm.
And then you. Also,
casting one.
Casting two.
Yeah. Casting one and casting two. I will explain you when it comes. Okay. First, we will discuss on the work scheduling.
Okay.
Okay. So, for a manufacturing product, this work scheduling view is a mandatory. It is a mandatory. Because this view will control your production order process. Controls your production order process. Here, the main important thing is production scheduling profile. Production scheduling profile. This profile is a configuration setting. It contains the details about your production order. Some controls about this production order.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. This is a configuration setting. I think there is no settings for this plant. I will create a configuration and I will show you. I'm going to SPRO. I'm just copying the one of the plants. Okay. So here, this profile is mainly for production order. Production order. So while creating a production order, what is the behavior of different fields? For example, if you want to release a production order, during release, you want to print the production order, you can tick mark this one.
Mm-hmm.
So system automatically print your production order.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. While these are the automatic actions, while creating your production order, you want to do some automatic actions, you can select. Same way you want to link documents. The documents from BOM or documents from material, you want to link to a production order, you can tick mark this.
Mm-hmm.
Here release. So while creating an order, you want to make release also as automatic. Like purchase order release, you want to release that as a production order. Automatically, you can select this tick mark.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And then in the bottom, you have the automatic goods receipt.
Mm-hmm.
Automatic goods receipt means while doing confirmation, you want to do the GR also for a production order. You can tick mark this. You want to check the availability of a component. You can tick mark this one. And in production, you will have a capacity planning actually. For that, you can select this profile, capacity planning profile.
Capacity, yes.
Yeah, capacity. That it will come in the later classes. Okay. And here, batch creation. Batch means for any product, you can manage the stocks in batches also.
Okay. Where this screen come from? I will show you
once I explain this one. I can show it. Okay. Mm-hmm. Okay. So this batch creation control also possible from this production scheduling profile. You want to create automatically in the order, you can select the settings. While release only, you want to create the order, you can select this. And in production, everything will control with order type. Okay. So which order type you want to use for this material, you can select this. I am putting standard order type present, PP01. Okay. So these are the main settings which control your creation of a production order. This is production scheduling profile. And I am saving this for this plant. So this profile is saved. So I will show you now SPRO path for this configuration. Go to SPRO. You can click SAP reference IMG, and here you can see the path for production. This is a production path. I'm just checking. Give me a second. Yeah. Under production, go to shop floor control, expand master data. Here you can see define production scheduling profile. Okay. Here, this is what we created now. Okay. If you want to know the transaction code, this is the transaction code, OPKP. Okay.
Now, after the session, do I have a login that we can do the practice?
Yeah, you can do the practice. You got the login and password?
Yeah. What link do we use to come on?
Yeah, you can do configuration. This is for your practice only.
Right.
You can do your practice and you create the material and everything. Whatever I'm telling you in the class, you practice that. Okay.
Yeah.
While you practice.
I'm talking about after the class when we do the practice.
Okay.
Can you send us a link or anything that we can practice
with? Yeah. Did you get the login and password?
No, not yet, because we didn't finish our paperwork with Murali. Maybe today or tomorrow we will have everything.
Okay. Okay. Once you did that one, I think you will get all the details, login, password, and everything.
Okay, great. Can I ask a question?
Yes.
When you are explaining, for example, the scheduling the profile,
okay.
Maybe you can tell us what is the best in the best practice. What is the best practice when you do production profile, for example, scheduling production profile. Maybe you give an idea, for example, what is the best practice, you know? Surely because you were working the production for many projects and you have a better idea of what it should be.
Yes, correct. Okay. Example, in this example, the best way is while doing the releasing the of production, you can release the printing also. You can do the printing also. Okay.
One time, or we can repeat the printing, or how it will work out.
It will get printed whenever you release the each production order.
Okay.
You want to reprint the production order? We have separate transaction code.
Okay. Got it. Okay, great.
Okay. Automatically, it will get printed, so you don't require to again do any action. Okay.
Great.
Okay. So. Best practice is you can copy from the existing plant like 0001 or 1000 plant SAP standard.
Yeah.
Okay. Once you copy that, these settings are based on the actually customer requirement, client requirement, or best thing is printing. On creation, you can select the release and auto goods movements. Okay. And you can select the what is the order type. By default, it will come. Okay. Order type, batch creation. These are the best practice, means you can say you need to default to these values.
Okay, great.
Okay. So now I am going back to material creation. So in scheduling profile, whatever we selected, you can select now. Whatever we created, you select that value. Mm-hmm. Okay. And next is unit of issue. Unit of issue means, for example, we created a base unit as each. Base unit is a each. But if you have a different unit of measure, for unit of measure, unit of issue or production unit. Production unit means, for example, bottles are there, Coke bottle. Bottle is a each. But when you produce that one, you are making that as a 10 bottles as one box. Mm-hmm. So you want to make production unit as a box. So you can maintain this here box. Mm-hmm. And the conversion, one box is equal to 10 each. That conversion you will maintain in additional data. Mm-hmm. So you can use alternative unit of measure also for production. So whenever you are producing this order, it will always show you the production unit. Mm-hmm. If you not maintain this value, it will show you base unit only. Mm-hmm. So you can use the multiple in this screen. The next important thing is batch management. Batch management means you can maintain your stock using a batch number. And each batch can have different characteristic values. Characteristic is
we already mentioned it in the production schedule profile. It should come automatic, is that right or not? We already mentioned it in production schedule profile. We put the flag in the batch management Is that the same?
Yeah. No, yeah. No, it is different. Okay. In production scheduling profile, there is a batch management auto creation. Auto creation means it will create a batch number automatically. Batch number. Batch number is like ABCD 123 is a batch number.
So in okay. other words, when you click the batch management, that will be created automatically, right?
Yeah, correct. Okay. So
what the production version?
Production version.
Yeah.
I will come it later. Let me explain this batch management, then I will come. Okay.
Now so the batch management has two check marks. One is batch management, the other one is batch management. Is it that plant level or what is the difference?
Yeah, this is batch management if you want specific to a plant level.
I see.
Okay. But this one is a general batch management.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So if we activate this batch management, that means your stock you are going to maintain as a batches. Okay. And once we activate this batch, you cannot deactivate it. You cannot remove this field. Once you activate and did some transactions like posting a stock, if you did that one, you cannot remove this one. So before activating this for any material, you need to check with the client that this material is a batch managed or not a batch managed.
So in other words, before you save the data, means MM01, before you save, then you can change. Otherwise, after you save, you cannot change the batch management. Is that correct?
Not exactly. You can save also. After save also, you can remove also. But if you did any transaction codes, any transactions, like stock posted for this material. Okay. After stock posting, you cannot remove this one. Okay, before stock posting or before creation of a order, you can change. But if you create any order or any stock postings, any planning, so after that you cannot remove this one. This tick mark. Okay. If you maintain this one, means you must maintain the material in batches only. So that is the reason this is an important field. You need to check with the client, then only you can create. Okay. And if somebody want the batch management after some stock posting, you cannot activate also. You cannot remove, you cannot activate also. Okay. If you did any transactions. Okay. And presently, I'm not using this batch management. But after one flow is completed, then I will show you how this batch management will work. Okay.
Yeah.
First, I will finish one flow, MTS flow, from starting to ending. After that, I will come to a these are the sub scenarios. Okay. Now, next is you are asking about the production version, but this production version is another master data. Okay, I will come back after our PP master data. Means you can see these are the PP master data, material master, BOM, work center, routing and production version. I will cover after routing this production version. Okay. So next important thing is like tolerances, under tolerance, over tolerance and unlimited. So these are the tolerance percentages. Okay, for example, over tolerance, if you put 10%, that means you created a production order with 50. quantity is 50. Okay, you can do the GR, production GR, after completion of production. System will allow only 50, because you created order for 50, it will do the GR also 50 on. But if you maintain over delivery tolerance like 10%, so you can do more than you can do up to 10% more. Like in 50, 10% is 55, so you can do the GR up to 55 also. System will allow automatically. Okay, extra production system will allow as per this tolerance. If you not maintain any tolerance, system will not allow. It will say you have created 50 only, so you are doing GR only 50. Okay. If you tick mark unlimited here, unlimited, if you tick mark that one, so unlimited GR you can do. Like you created 50 only, but you can do the GR 5000 also. Unlimited, there is no limit. Okay, so the control for GR as per your production order is based on this tick mark and percentage.
Okay,
okay,
can you go back to the Excel file, please?
Excel,
yeah. If the production order is 50 and GR you say unlimited 5000, so if this will be go 5000 to production order?
Yes, this 5000 will go to a production order.
I see. Okay.
Okay. Against this production order, I am doing the GR. Like against your purchase order number, you will do the MIGO. Okay. So like that, if for example your production order number is like this, and for this production order I can do the GR 5000 also if you tick mark unlimited. Okay,
well, what about the when you create the material and you mention each something, that doesn't affect on number of the product?
So you mean to say production unit?
Yes.
If you put box, then your production unit become as a box. If you maintain like example like box here, okay, so then your production order will show you 50 boxes. It will show you in box only. Okay, and GR also will happen with the box.
5000 box. Okay.
5000 boxes, but actually 5000 is nothing but a one box equal to 10 bottles, 10 each. So then it is actually 50,000 each if you convert this into the each.
Right.
Okay. Okay. So these are the important fields in this work scheduling view. Okay. So with this MRP 1, 2, 3, 4 and work scheduling, these are the main views for PP related materials, means production related materials, MRP 1, 2, 3, 4 and work scheduling.
Can you now please go to basic data and I want to just take the screenshot since I was not
Okay. Okay. Before that, I need to save this. Now I am in MM01. Okay.
Yeah.
Let me save it. So I will open in change mode. Okay. Okay. So basic data one, there is no much difference from ECC to S4HANA. Here mainly we will maintain the basic data one, means unit of measure. base unit of measure, as this is a FG material. And if you go to the MRP 1, the PP related main important thing is MRP type, lot size, and MRP controller. In previous class, actually, I explained all these details. I think you can check your video. I think Murali will have sent to you my video. The total explanation is there. Okay. And MRP 2, important thing is like procurement type and special procurement type, and then in-house production, safety stock, schedule margin key. And in MRP 3, strategy group and availability check. And in MRP 4, whether it is a scraps, we discussed actually. We have three kind of scraps: assembly scrap, component scrap, and operational scrap. Those percentages you can maintain here. If it is a repetitive manufacturing, we will do the setting here. Okay. So these we discussed in previous class, and now we discuss this work scheduling view. So now I am going to accounting views, because we need accounting views for costing purpose only. As a PP module, we don't require accounting views. That will be maintained by finance people, FICO team. But why we need to maintain is, while creating production order, system will calculate planned cost and actual cost.
So when you were on MM01, you cannot do at the same time accounting one, accounting two, then you go back to again and then put the material and come back again to accounting one.
You can do.
Okay.
You can do. Okay. You need to open the MM01 and update the, make the first, these views are available. You can do that.
Okay.
Okay. So in accounting view, why we need accounting and costing is mainly price of the product. Okay. While creating our production order, system will expect some price. What is the price of product? So if you not maintain this one, we will get the errors in costing, production order costing. So that is the reason we are maintaining these also. Okay. In accounting one, first we need to maintain what is the valuation class. Okay. I am selecting the default one, like a standard SAP 7920. And we need to maintain price control. Price control have the two types. One is the standard price or variable price. Generally for FG and SFG materials, we will use the standard price. For raw materials, we will use the moving average price.
Now, when you work on MM01, we say, who will give us the price, like the standard price and moving price? Is there any other department who give it to us?
Yes. Actually, first thing is client will tell you what is the price. Client, okay? In the from the client side, finance people will they will give accounting, not the finance, accounting people they will give. Okay, in SAP side, these prices will be updated by FICO team, FICO team. Okay, they will update using this transaction code MM02, or they have a separate transaction MR21. Using those transaction codes, they will update these prices. So if it is a standard price, we will maintain some price here, standard price. Okay. If it is a variable price is selected, we need to enter the variable price here. Okay. So then the costing and accounting view related, only this is only the setting is required. Valuation class and what is the price. Okay. So the remaining tabs, we don't require to maintain any values here. Only just select the tab. Because in accounting one, whatever you maintain, again it will appear in costing two, same data.
Yeah, can you go to costing one more time?
Yeah.
So nothing will be maintained here.
Yeah, nothing is required. Actually, if you want to maintain, you can maintain the profit center. Okay, like cost center. So this profit from this material will go to this profit center.
Okay. And costing two has a lot of this is the same thing.
Okay. If they run costing, you will get the future cost, previous cost. Previous means previous period. Maybe last month, what is the cost? You can get it here. This is current month is 100. What is the future next month? How it will be the cost? You can get. Okay.
Now you can save the data, and your material master is created.
Correct. I clicked on the save button, so material is created now. Now you can open in change mode, MM02, and if you want to change any value from the accounting or work scheduling, you can do the changes.
I see.
Okay. You want to change any profile, or you want to maintain some tolerance like 10%, you can do this value. Okay. And in accounting, you know, one, you want to, okay, you want to change the standard price after saving this one. You cannot do using the MM02, but you have another transaction MR21. From there, you can do actually.
You say MR21?
Yeah, MR.
This is 21.
Yeah, using this, you can change. Okay, so the pricing part and everything, your finance people will check. Yeah. And alternate unit of measure, like your production unit is different and this one is different here. So first thing is, what you need to do is go to the additional data here, and here in the additional data, unit of measure, you can maintain here first. Like one, you want to make this as a box is equal to 10 each. First you maintain here. Maybe box is not there, unit box is not created. Okay, let me check any other.
Maybe case CV.
Yeah, CV. Yeah, case.
CV.
Okay. Yeah, yeah. Okay. You can maintain like one CV is equal to 10 each. You maintain it here first, and then you can enter the CV here. Okay. So whenever you created a production order, your unit of measure will come as a CV. Okay. But as we took the example as car, we won't maintain this as a case. So I'm removing it. But if you create any Coke bottle or anything kind of this one, you can use this. Okay.
Okay. Now you said that when you finish this, when you say it, after that you run a production version. So are you trying to work on a production over today? Are you trying to work on that one?
No, production order. Once we complete all the master data, then only we can create production order.
No, not the production order, the production version.
Yeah. Production order.
I see.
We will first complete all the master data, then we will go to the production order. So once master data is completed, we will do the make to stock scenario, like forecast, MRP run, planned order, then convert all these steps. This is end-to-end cycle. Mm-hmm. If I directly go to the production order, you will get confused. What is the starting and what is the ending as a process? Okay. So I will go with this process. Okay. In MTS scenario, what is the starting and ending? To follow this process, we need master data. So I have created the master data. Okay. Okay. We created one FG material. So like this, I will create one more material, raw material. Okay. So we can use these two materials for our practice. Like raw material is like a tire, Honda tire. Creating raw material. If you want to create a raw material, you need purchasing data as a mandatory purchasing view. Right. And basic data is a mandatory purchasing. And after that, MRP, if you want to maintain, you can maintain the MRP and then costing. Okay.
So MRP, yes. You can use all of them.
Yeah. Actually, MRP, all of them is not required. It is not a mandatory. Okay. You can use MRP 1-2. But if we extend the views, there is no issue. Okay. You can take MRP 1-2. Okay. Because you want to do the planning for this raw material also. Planning means MRP run. During MRP run, what is the required for this component, you need MRP 1. Okay, MRP 1 and 2 you need. These two tabs is required for MRP planning run. MRP run. Okay, so that is the reason you can select the MRP also for raw material. And accounting and costing is for the purpose of you can maintain what is the cost. So you can select
this one is a new configuration for S/4HANA.
Yes. Yeah, this is S/4HANA.
When you select raw material, appropriate maybe to have it semi-fini product or no? No, maybe you have a better idea. I'm talking about the thing. I see to be a raw material, it can be semi-fini.
Do you mean this tire can be a semi-finished?
Yeah, this one must be. Just maybe a question, what you think about it? No,
yeah, you can make this as also semi-finished also.
Okay,
this can be made as a semi-finished also.
For example, material master in HANA, Is the HANA has a material master different transaction code?
No, same transaction code MM01 and MM02.
But it's here, but here material age transaction is OMX2. What is it?
Yeah, actually, this is one error is coming that material ledger must be set as a product two while creating this raw material. Okay, so material ledger is mandatory, it is saying for that these are the process it is explaining you to do to make this material ledger as active in S4 HANA, but this is not related to your material creation. Okay, OMX2, let me activate this actually. This is actually the finance people, they will do the this is setting actually for this plant OMX2.
Just to let you know, sir, I'm dropping the call within 2 minutes because I have another call.
Yeah, okay. I will close for today. Okay. Yeah. I'm closing here today. So tomorrow we will continue the class. Okay.
Okay, no problem. I appreciate it. Thank you for your time. Have a good day. Yeah, have a good day. Good night, Jamal.
Can you give me the link that last class that I want to listen it?
Yeah, okay. I will ask the Murali to send it to you. Okay.
Okay.
Okay, thank you. Thank you very much. Good night.
Thank you.
Bye.
Good day. Good night. Thank you, sir.
Yeah, bye.
And I will.
Yes.
And also, I want to talk to him that I need the SAP link that I have to work on it.
Like okay.
Or a practice on a SPRO or whatever.
Okay. Sure. I will ask him to provide that also. Okay.
Yeah. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you. Bye. Bye. Have a nice day.